And can AI and blockchain technology get food to your door faster and fresher? Domino's Pizza of Singapore and Malaysia is banking on just that by partnering with SingularityNet, a leading AI company, to improve their most pressing supply chain and logistical challenges. Archie's Brent Jabour sat down with SingularityNet Chief Marketing Officer Arif Khan to discuss the innovative deal.
You guys are talking about here today is your work with Domino's Pizza in Southeast Asia to basically help the supply chain move more efficiently. Tell me about what you guys are doing.
Yeah, happy to. So I think the partnership with them in Malaysia and Singapore as a pilot is to really help equip them with some of the algorithms that would allow them to do door-to-door delivery as efficiently as possible. And if you look at the broader delivery landscape and how it has evolved with new technological innovators like Uber Eats or Grab or all of these partners that have come on board, you really need to be able to serve customer demand, sometimes in an anticipatory way, so you understand what they're likely to purchase, but also in a very efficient way, so that your promise of delivering something on time is going to be met. And that includes understanding, you know, several different data inputs. What's the weather going to be like? How are we going to route our drivers on time as efficiently as possible? How do we make sure that the pizza is as fresh as possible when a customer gets it? So all of these would be combined into a nice algorithm that would allow them to effectively deliver these efficiencies at scale.
And how, working with Domino's Pizza, this is a large pizza chain throughout the world, how receptive have they been to the idea of what you guys proposed initially and now where we are today?
Yeah, I think one thing that's really unique about food services providers or large companies that are in the Fortune 1000, they have a mandate to innovate and grow and scale. And what we found from the Malaysia and Singapore leadership team is a lot of openness to really try and test this out. And that's where the goodwill from our side and their side has allowed us to do this as a pilot. Because bringing AI and blockchain into an organization is not something that people would do lightly. It takes a lot of education and learning both from our side and from their side as well.
And how does AI and blockchain work together? Why do we have to have these two great tastes that taste great together? Why do they work so well together?
Yeah, that's an important question. So we have a large community of about 100,000 people, and we have a token holding community that believes in the vision that we're building. So I'll give you and your viewers a very simple example. There's narrow AI. A narrow AI application is, I don't know, let's say what's topical right now, Facebook's newsfeed, right? Mm-hmm. An algorithm that's designed solely for the purpose of maximizing your attention. Mm-hmm. And then it has the core aim of driving revenue from advertisers to your newsfeed, and it keeps you captured and hooked. And that's one algorithm that's just there forever to make sure that you're very narrowly focused on a core objective. Now, what's really interesting is, if you want to look at AI that can decontextualize, that can take itself out from that narrow standpoint and be general, that's really where a lot of companies are focusing their attention on. And at the general level, there are very few companies that are actually achieving this or making progress towards it, because it's dependent on the data sets that you're able to acquire. There are a large number of crypto projects, blockchain-based projects, that are looking at data marketplaces, places where you can store data so that people can have open access to data. This, of course, goes against the general sort of modern day technology companies that have data moats and firewalls that are not necessarily willing to share that data. So you need that data to be open, and blockchain certainly provides that open sort of data layer. And then you need an algorithm layer, an AI layer, that takes the data, shapes it into something meaningful that can drive strategy or something good for organizations.
In the long run, you could, especially with the nature of the block, which is to have a information that's out there and not completely trustless, if you will, but not completely like open, but it is able to be shared and viewed without being manipulated.
Yes.
So could this be a future where we could see, like, okay, well, we start with Domino's, well, then we get to, you know, Uber Eats Singapore or whatever it else might be, and sharing that data?
Yeah, I think that's an interesting way of looking at open sort of data protocols that allow organizations to share their data and access it at a at a level which allows them to collaborate. There are some experiments going on in this domain. But enterprises today are concerned about their data and their data rights, and so they're okay to experiment within a data set that as long as they have certain access controls and permissions. And that's fine as a start. What we're going there to do is let all of these partners of ours have access to their data, but we will build the algorithms for them that allow them to then scale and ship and make use of these data sets. Because remember, the data innovation, as much as we are in blockchain and technology, a large number of companies don't fully understand the value of the data that they're sitting on. And neither do we as consumers. You don't understand the value of the data that you give up when you read your news feed, right? The feed is reading you as much as you think that you're reading the news feed. So really, at the end of the day, it comes back down to how we think about data, how we equip organizations to create meaning from that data. And sometimes creating the right algorithms is the key to driving those insights.
When do
So hopefully you enjoyed this one. It was a little bit longer, but I think it's very important to share what to look for in the future of blockchain and how it can be working with artificial intelligence. And just on another side note, we just had a huge bump up in the price of Bitcoin, as you can see in the 3 month chart. And we'll see if Bitcoin can stay at the 8,000 level. My feeling is that we will probably have another little correction, but it's a good sign for crypto. I have not sold any of my crypto holdings, and I was making purchases, if you've been following this channel, since Bitcoin was 3,000. I was buying the dip, and I don't plan on selling any of my crypto until we see the highs of 30. I'm hoping to see Bitcoin hit 30,000, but if not, I'm not selling anything until I see Bitcoin hit 20,000 again. But let me know your thoughts on this and the future of cryptocurrency technology with artificial intelligence, and I will talk to you guys soon.